Now the special cases are, if point K lies on the axial line of the dipole. Axial line of the dipole means this point K lies here. In that case, we know that the resultant intensity should be along the axial line. So this alpha should be 0, then only it becomes along KL. So putting, it will be on axial line only when this angle theta becomes 0. So putting theta is equal to 0, we will get tangent alpha is equal to 1 by 2 tangent 0, which is equal to 0. And tangent 0 means alpha is equal to 0. Right? So it is clear that alpha is equal to 0. So direction is along KL. Right? And the value, if we want to calculate, E vector is equal to P upon 4 pi epsilon naught R cube. You can see here root 3 cos square theta. Cos square 0 is 1. So 3 plus 1. It becomes 2 P upon 4 pi epsilon naught R cube, which is the exact value. And direction is along the axial line. Second case, when K lies on equatorial line, equatorial line means this K lies at this point, so this theta becomes 90 degree. So theta is equal to 90 degree. Tangent alpha is equal to 1 by 2 tangent of 90 degree equal to infinite, or alpha is equal to 90 degree. That is, in this case, alpha becomes 90 degree. Alpha becomes 90 degree means alpha becomes this along KM. Alpha becomes KM. So if we keep this line here, so alpha will become, our result along this. That is opposite to the dipole BA, along BA, or we can say opposite to the dipole AB. So it will be correct. That is, and the value of E can be calculated, it P upon 4 pi epsilon naught R cube, root 3 cos 90 is 0, so 1. So that is P upon 4 pi epsilon naught R cube, and opposite to the direction of dipole, right?